Good morning, vlog. I was up late night giggling on the phone with boyfriend and I just overslept. I also just consciously noticed me doing that on camera. I twitch, my elbow twitches while I film. Usually people notice that on TikTok. They're like, girl, what's wrong with your arm? Why is it flailing? What's with the flailing arm? I'm like, I don't know. I don't usually notice it until I watch the clip back. Anyways, hi, vlog. Good morning. I didn't oversleep by too much, but I definitely shouldn't be doing this right now. I don't have time to be doing this, but I have a Pilates class. But I thought I would vlog my Saturday for you guys. So I had, even though I don't have time to be doing this, I'm still doing it because we're spending the day together. I would also like to mention that I was having a relaxing day yesterday, so I was just pounding edibles all day long. I ate an edible and then I went to go get a massage, and then I ate another edible. And I laid on the couch and I watched She's All That for the first time. I've never seen that movie. So that was fun. Okay, I'll show you my Pilates outfit. The Aloe 5-inch, I believe, shorts. This black t-shirt is from Nudes. And then I'm also going to throw on my little Sherpa because it's cold. I've been really enjoying it. It's been cold this week in LA. Like yesterday, I whipped out the puffer because it was so cold. So I get to wear my big cozy jackets. Big win. I've been trying to get back into Pilates. Before the other day, I haven't done it since October, but I only did it once in October. I was good about it over the summer, but I like pushed myself too hard, so I stopped doing it. I went like every single day for 2 weeks in a row, and then I just like never did it again. So I'm trying to get back into it because my goal, this is my fitness goal. My fitness routine goal is to do Pilates every week, Monday, no. It's to do Pilates every week, Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, and then to run at the gym like normal Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and then have Sunday off. That's like my goal, but I can't start off like that because I did Pilates the other day maybe on like Tuesday, and I have been so incredibly sore that I haven't been able to walk for like the past 4 days. I seriously almost overslept and missed my class. It wasn't that bad. I woke up at 7:30. I was supposed to get up at 7. I woke up at 7:30. My class is at 8:20. It's 8 right now, so we're chilling. I've never just like slept through a Pilates class though. Like imagine if I did, because they're like $40 each. That's a great like Christmas gift to get. Like if you have any Pilates people in your life, that's a great gift to get them, like a bunch of classes, because you can prepay for Pilates classes and like buy them ahead of time. At least with, I go to Solid Core, at least you can do that at Solid Core. You can probably do that at other Pilates studios though too. That is a great gift to get someone. I made gift guides yesterday, by the way, you guys. I made gift guides for her and for him yesterday on my ShopMy. I'll link them down below. I think I did a pretty good job. So if you're having issues choosing gifts for the loved hers and the loved hims in your life, I got you. Am I even more cringy in the... No, I'm less cringy in the morning. I've always known that about myself just from rewatching like old videos and things of the sort. I've noticed that I'm far less cringy in the morning time when I'm still like a little out of it. And then once the afternoon rolls around, it's bad. But then it gets better again at nighttime. These fuck BT Dubs, the Aminolean, best energy drink I've ever had. I tried them for the first time the other day. So good. This one is the strawberry watermelon flavor. And then I also like the cherry lime and the berry elixir. They're very good. Okay, I should probably drive to my class now. I'm like literally sitting on the side of the road. Because I got a new camera mount for my car. So I thought that I would be able to like drive and vlog at the same time. But I think it's just my Jeep. Because my Jeep is very bumpy. Okay, so I don't think any camera mount's ever going to work. Because it's just going to shake the whole time. And I don't want to make you guys... I don't want to shake you around, give you a headache, so I pulled over on the side of the road.
Toes are going to be on your black side flat. All right, friends. So, in terms of inner thighs, and you have your chest today. So, for your inner thighs, we're going to activate here.
I'm already getting back into the swing of things, okay? So the last class I went to on Tuesday, I fell when I walked outside of the studio. My legs gave out because it was hamstring day, and I stumbled and fell. Today I'm feeling a bit better. Also, so I go to the Solid Core studio in my old apartment building. This is the apartment building that I lived in for like 2.5 years when I first moved here, and they just opened a coffee shop. called Stereoscope Coffee, and it's so good, and the people in there are so kind, and I had a lovely conversation. It's just funny because they started making all these things while I still lived here, but now that I'm gone, just in my apartment building, there's a Pilates studio, a yoga studio, a grocery store, a juice bar, a coffee shop, and then like the amenities, obviously. So like the pool, the gym, like all that stuff. It's like you never have to leave if you live here. My biggest issue with this place was obviously the area. It's in Hollywood. In my peripheral right now, I can see a man jerking off, a man cleaning the sidewalk, like scrubbing the sidewalk with his hoodie. Oh, that lady's stripping. And see, like, I know it seems like I'm like joking around about this, but it is a really depressing thing to be around. All of the homeless, and especially the ones that are like losing their minds, it's a really sad thing to watch. So I didn't love living here just because it made me really depressed every time I left my apartment. But I'm gonna head home now because I didn't even have time to wake up the bird this morning. It's literally 9:15 and the bird is still in bed. So I have to go wake everyone up. I'm putting away laundry. I obviously didn't have time to do like my morning clean this morning because I was sleeping. The reason I slept through my alarm was not only because I was up late on the phone with boyfriend giggling, I had a serving nightmare. I honestly don't have serving nightmares that often, which I'm very grateful for, but you will have no idea what I'm talking about if you've never been a server before. Serving nightmares are brutal, and every time I have one, I sleep through my alarm. My dad gets serving nightmares like twice a week. I only get them like once every few months, so that's great. But I just fed everyone, I cleaned the kitchen, I did the dishes, and I just like made my bed and cleaned the bathroom and stuff, and now I'm just putting away some laundry. And then I'm gonna make breakfast! I'm so hungry. You guys, so I'm so specific about like the way my crew necks and hoodies like hang on my body. I don't like when they're too thick. I don't like when they're stiff. I don't like that thing at the bottom that like cinches inwards. I just don't like that. And I've never in my life found a crew neck that was just perfect until the other day. I found my most perfect crew neck. I'll insert a photo right here of just like the way it hangs on me. It's just so oversized and like lightweight. It's not stiff. It doesn't cinch anywhere. It just hangs. It's so cute. I got it from Aloe. I forget what it's called, but I'll link it down below. I got mine in an XL. I think it's just called like the chill crew neck, but I got it in an XL and it's perfect. So I'll link it down below for you guys. I've been wearing it every single day and I haven't washed it yet because I wear it every day and there's kind of like stains that are getting on it, but I was at Jenny Kane a few weeks ago, trying on cardigans as I do, and I smelled this candle, but I didn't buy it. I left, and I was thinking about it for like weeks, so I went back to go get it, and I lit it like maybe an hour ago. This is like the best candle I've ever lit. I'm a huge fan of the Salt and Stone candles. Those are like my favorites. I'm just obsessed with candles in general, but the Salt and Stone is my favorite. I think this one might take the number one spot. And it's just so pretty and like simple looking. What scent is this? It's called Aspen. It's balsam fir, eucalyptus, cypress, and grapefruit. It's so good. It's like smelling up my whole apartment right now. I'll link it down below. It's really good. I tried to make a simmer pot the other day. I tried to make a simmer pot the other day because I've never even heard of simmer pots until Maggie McDonald did one on her YouTube channel. So I got like apple, oranges, cranberries, cinnamon, and cloves. And I boiled it on my stove. I didn't simmer it, I boiled it. I think that's where I went wrong and I ruined my pan. I hated the smell, first of all. I don't know, I don't think I like the smell of cinnamon, and I put way too much cinnamon in it, so it gave me a headache. Like, I didn't like the smell to begin with. But then I look over, because I hear something, and I realized all the water had boiled out of the pot, and everything was just kind of like burning in there. Colin scrubbed it to his best ability on the inside, but this is what my pot looks like now. Simmer pot gone wrong. So that's that. I made my fake eggs and I made my fake bacon that totally resembles like bacon strips for dogs, but it tastes good, so it's okay. I've been making my vegan eggs differently. I've been making them like the slow cooking way, where how you make like the soft scrambled eggs. I've been doing that with my little rubber spatula, and it's good. I've never seen the movie She's the Man ever until last night. I decided I was gonna eat a little edible and watch She's the Man, and my boyfriend like knows nothing of pop culture. It's like really funny. He doesn't know anything, and he was like, hey, did you die? Because I wasn't texting him back. I was like, oh no, I'm just mesmerized by 2006 Amanda Bynes. And he was like, who's Amanda Bynes? It was so crazy. I was like, you don't know who Amanda Bynes is? How? What's the other thing? There was another thing yesterday that he didn't know. Oh, Ozempic. He didn't know what Ozempic was. I was making my gift guides and I was on the phone with him. I was like, oh my God, I have the most brilliant idea. I'm going to add Ozempic to the For Her gift guide. He was like, what's Ozempic? I haven't brought this up in like over a year, I think, so I need to tell you guys again. I found this product like a year and a half ago in the fragrance category. It's actually Scentbird's sister company, and you guys know how much I love Scentbird and everything they do. But this brand is called Drift. They make air care products for your car and for your home. I use them in both. I have one clipped in my bedroom, and then I always have one clipped up on my visor. Also, all of the materials that they use are sustainable, and their scents are all made with natural, essential, and fragrance oils, so these are great. And their car products all range from like $9 to $15, so they're super affordable as well. I just got my scent of the month in the mail, so I figured I would show you guys. This one's called Grove. It's mountain greens and sugared citrus. Every month they do like a new limited edition scent that's inspired by the season. They're really good at capturing like the memories and emotions like attached with each season, which I love. So let's smell this one. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Wait, I'm freaking out. I just clipped it up on my visor. This is what it looks like. It's just like a clip with like a magnet attached, and then you just stick the new like little wooden thing on the magnet every month. So it's super easy to like switch out. What's cool about these car fresheners is you can get them as like a subscription. So for your first month, you get the starter kit with like the clip and the scent. And then after that, you can just get like monthly refills, and it's super easy to like swap them out. They recommend changing them every 30 days. And it's nice to have variety and like different scents every month, so you don't go nose blind. You know, when you have like a certain car freshener forever and then you don't smell it anymore, with this, that never happens. And the subscription is super flexible, so you can like cancel at any time. You can change your scent at any time. You can change your delivery frequency. This scent honestly reminds me of like, I used to stay in this cabin in New Hampshire like all throughout the year, but like specifically in the fall, and like make this like lemon ginger tea. So this is reminding me of like being in the cabin and like drinking my tea. I love it so much. Also, it's so funny when people get into my car, they're like, wait, your car freshener is so like aesthetically pleasing. Like, look at this. It's so cute. It's so much prettier than like any other car freshener, obviously, that I've ever had. Like, this is just so cute, and it just sticks right here. I also have a code for you guys. My code is TowersWorld for 55% off your first month. That means it's only like $5 for your first month. That is insane. So use my code TowersWorld for 55% off. I'll put the link down below for you guys. Thank you so much, Drift, for partnering with me on this video. I love you guys so much. You are awesome. I love your brand. I love everything about your brand. You're amazing. And I want all of you guys to try this because it seriously changed my life. So thank you so much, Drift. So I wanted to do like a big giveaway for you guys. A lot of this stuff is PR that I've received because I just get way too much of it. So some of this stuff is PR, and then I also went out the other day and bought some stuff too, like some of my favorite products that I really wanted you guys to have as well. I'll show you all of the products in a second, but all you have to do to enter is make sure you're subscribed to my YouTube channel and you like this video, and then comment down below. You can comment whatever you want. I'm splitting all this stuff into three batches, so it's technically three giveaways. So one of them is this one, and then the other two are on Instagram and TikTok. So if you want two extra chances to win, you can go enter those giveaways as well. But I'll show you everything right now. This is all the stuff right here. We have some Athena Club. We have a bunch of L'Occitane products. These are a bunch of minis, but then there's some full-sized ones as well, like the milk concentrate, the shower oil. They're like nighttime reset serum. We have some skincare from Verst or Versed. I don't really know how to pronounce it, but it's either one of those. And then we have some Elemis skincare as well. I love this stuff. The Pro Collagen Cleansing Balm is so good. We have some Ole Henriksen, this cute little like Sol de Janeiro trio pack. I love these two products, the Aloe Luminizing Face Moisturizer and the Head to Toe Glow Oil. We have some Glow Recipe. These are the niacin
Niacinamide Dewdrops. I love these. And then that one is the toner. My favorite lip products in the entire world, the Summer Fridays Lip Butter Balm in Sweet Mint. These are a bunch of lip products as well. We have ColourPop, Huda Beauty, Hard Candy. This Peter Thomas Roth, like, lip plumping stuff is so good. I have one in my bathroom and it just has like a pale pink tint. It's really cute. These two from Peter Thomas Roth are so good. These are the under eye detox patches that I use. A bunch of hair products, the Grande Lash, Grande Brow, and Grande Lips. These are like non-nicotine vapes. I actually really like these. They all target different things. Like, there's like a sleep one, energy, happy, relax. This is the magnesium powder that I take every night. I put it in like my Sleepy Girl mocktails. I love it. But yeah, I'm gonna split all this up in three batches to the best of my ability. So just subscribe, like, and comment to enter. And you can enter the Instagram and TikTok giveaways as well. I just put on a cute outfit to leave the house. I was like, wait, why would I do that? And then I was like, ah, fuck it. Because I got this puffer the other day, this puffer vest, and I have been making it my whole personality, but that's okay. I got this cropped puffer vest from Lululemon, and I can't stop talking about it. It is all I've been talking about since I have purchased it 3 days ago, but I'll link it down below. It's really cute. I'm obsessed with it. And I'm wearing this little Aritzia, like, tight long sleeve and my girlfriend denim jeans, the dark wash ones. I was gonna be super dramatic and wear my whip out the Prada snow boots today, but it's 70 degrees. I can't whip out the snow boots yet. Also, I forgot to show you guys. So the other day, so I'm so used to wearing like a bunch of rings, and recently I've only been wearing my two Cartier rings and nothing else. But for the past few months, I've been really wanting to get one more ring. So I've been looking at this one from Tiffany, and I was on Rodeo the other day, so I was like, let me pop in, see if they have it in stock. Of course they had it in stock, and so I had to get it. It's so cute. It's this one. It's like a little tie. It's a yellow gold, like, little diamond tie situation. So now I wear this one, my little Cartier love ring, and my Cartier nail ring, the, like, Un Cloud one. I'm not gonna put anything on my left ring finger because I'm saving that for bigger and better things, but I love my little ice situation that I have going on. So those are my rings, and then this one is from Love Sorrow. I went into the location on Melrose Place and they, like, welded this just, like, little dainty gold chain onto me. This is the Cartier nail bracelet, my Cartier love ring, this little, like, friendship bracelet looking thing that says happy, and then my necklace and my earrings are both from Every Jewels. Drip! Little bitch really fuck it up. On a handstand doing tricks, fuck it up. 847, little bitch fuck it up on the bitch of you. I feel cute. I don't know what to wear for shoes. I've been really craving, like, a tight pair of jeans. Because I'm in my jeans era, but I only have, like, low-rise baggy jeans, which I love, but recently I've been like, I want to wear a tight jean, but I don't know where to get those, so. Like, I wish I was wearing, like, a dark wash, like, fitted jean right now, but I don't have any. I have, like, 20 pairs of jeans and they're all baggy. Except for one pair of Levi's, but they're, like, high waters, like, severe high waters. I can't really wear those. And then I have another pair of tight jeans, but they're like Disney jeans. Like, they have, like, Pluto on them. So
I'm putting on perfume before I leave the house. I was just making a TikTok about how Colin doesn't know anything about pop culture. I told the whole world that he doesn't know who Amanda Bynes is, and he doesn't know what Ozempic is. He didn't know who the Sway Boys were. Like, come on, bro. I love how I have two perfumes now that I enjoy. It used to always just be Daisy Marc Jacobs. This is still my favorite, but now I also have the Baccarat Rouge. My dad bought me this. I think today I'm doing Daisy. This has always been my favorite. Since sixth grade, I've been wearing this perfume. It is the best. I love it. I love it. Also, should I be concerned? So, like, Colin wakes up at, like, 4:30 in the morning all week for work. So then on the weekends, he sleeps in really late because he, like, is catching up on sleep, you know? But he normally will sleep until, like, 11:30 in the morning. It's now 3 p.m. where he lives, and he is still not awake. And I'm like, should I be concerned? Like, I just keep texting him, like, are you good? 3 p.m. Like, I don't think... And he went to bed last night at, like,
1:30, like nothing crazy. I don't know. I'm filling up my coffee cup before I leave. This cold brew is so good, you guys. Specifically the vanilla flavor. Wandering Bear Vanilla Cold Brew. You can get it from Whole Foods. Best oat milk for coffees. Sorry, I can't stop talking. I'll shut up. Yeah, mommy won't shut up today. Mommy keeps slapping her jaw. Yeah, it's really annoying. I think you get that from your mommy, my love. You know how you just never stop talking? You never know when to shut up? Mommy does that too. Mm-hmm. Hi, I was wondering if I could make a reservation for tonight for 5:00. All right, thank you so much. I'll see you later. Bye. Going to Crossroads tonight. I'm at Petco because I had to pick up a couple of things, but I swear to God, the only time of year that I ever like wish I had a dog is this time of year, because there was a Santa in there taking pictures with dogs. It was so cute. All the dogs were like dressed up in their like Christmas pajamas. I had to get 2 Chinese takeout boxes for Marty because I've been to Petco for the past 2 weeks and they haven't had these, so I just keep checking. These are his favorites, so I got him these. And then I had to get cat food for Roger, Coulson, and Venus. They love this wet food. I don't know if you guys have cats, but they are feral for this. This Solistic Mystic Menu wet food. They love this. If y'all have cats and you need Rex, this is the good shit right here. It's gotten a little bit hot out since I left the house and now I look crazy in my puffer. It's like 70 degrees and I'm wearing a puffer vest. I had to pick up a couple things from Whole Foods. I'm gonna go home now, I'm like tired. But I'll show you what I got from Whole Foods first. I got more of this tart cherry juice because I've been making the like sleepy girl mocktail thing every single night. It's my new favorite thing in the world. So I just ran out of cherry juice, so I had to get some of that. Romaine lettuce for my salads and green onion. A sweet potato for my salads. I've been cutting up and roasting sweet potato and keeping it in the fridge for my salads recently, and it's so good. And then I got more eggs and a Honeycrisp apple for Marty because this is his new thing. He loves apples. And then I just got a singular egg roll, a singular vegetable egg roll. As soon as I got home from my errands, I got this comforter out of the closet and I laid down on the couch and started reading. I don't know why I'm so tired. Well, I've been reading and talking. Oh, I've been reading and I've been talking to Colin on the phone, and I was showing him we're going to New York City together for Christmas for like 2 nights for like a weekend. And I wanted to go to the, I think it's called the Winter Market, the thing at Bryant Park where they have like a bunch of food and stuff. And I was showing him this sandwich that they make that I know he's gonna love. And he like freaked out. He's so excited. Oh. Oh my God. He got so excited. This is the book I'm reading right now. I just started it. It's called The Silent Wife by Karen Slaughter. This is like my 8th Karen Slaughter book in the past month. I love her. Phoebe! Hello, my love! Oh. 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 Phoebe wanted to say hey. She wants reps.
I love you more than she is. Yet I do.
I want to know Phoebe's story so bad. So bad. I adopted her when she was 14. And I just need to know, like, Venus, you're in my shot. I need to know, like, who had her before me and how they gave her up. Phoebe's, like, the best cat I've ever met in my life. Besides you, Phoebe's the best cat I've ever met in my life. I don't understand how anyone could have ever given her up. I want to know if she was with multiple families. I want to know if she was only with one and like maybe her owner like died. I must know, but I don't think I ever will. If anyone has any information on Miss Phoebe here, I adopted her in Providence, Rhode Island while she was 14, and she came with the name Phoebe. So
I think I adopted her in like 2019, like early 2019. It was the winter of 2019, I believe. If anyone has any information, that'd be lovely. This is her. I would also like some information on Roger, if anyone could figure that out for me. Roger. My coworker at the time found him wandering the streets, so he didn't come with the name Roger, but he already had one eye, if that says anything. I'm pretty sure he had owners at one point, though, because he knew, like, he reacted positively to the sound of a can opening. So I don't think he was a street cat his whole life. We found him when he was about 3. That was the vet's guess. So he's a Russian blue and chartreuse mix. I'm feeding everyone before I start to get ready for dinner. But today, I don't feed my cats breakfast until I get back from Pilates, because it's still like super early that I get back from Pilates, so I wait until I get home to feed them. And there was like this stuff on my kitchen floor that looked like this. It looked just like this wet food. So I'm like, how did they get into the cans? Like, it was all over the floor. I'm like, so I looked in the cupboard where I keep the wet food, and there was no like can open. Like, they didn't get into it until I saw this. They knocked this pumpkin spice granola butter onto the floor, opened it up, and were like eating the granola butter. They turn into like savages when they're like a little hungry. So my cats eat everything. Like, Venus was like eating my like Funfetti cookie the other night. I was like,
I love feeding time. I know.
And this is what Marty has been eating this week. Broccoli, bell pepper, edamame, green beans, banana, tofu, cubed yam, blueberries, apple, and almonds. He has the same staples that I always feed him, but it switches up every week whenever I go to the grocery store. So this is what he's been eating this week. Come on, baby, what time is it? Did I just give it away?
No.
What are we thinking?
Edible.
I love you. I love you. It's edible time. You remember peanut butter jelly time?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Oh, you know something.
I love peanut butter jelly time, peanut butter jelly time. Do you remember the gummy bear song?
Yeah, of course. Do you remember, well, this is kind of niche, the nugget biscuit, dip it all in mashed potatoes, dip it all in mashed potatoes. Dip the mashed potatoes in a chicken nugget biscuit in the barbecue. Yum, yum, gimme!
Nope, don't remember that one.
Oh. Okay. That was a big bite.
Oh, yeah?
I'm trying to, like, live in heat.
In heat?
Yeah.
So always being honey?
No, that's not what I meant.
That's what it means when, like, an animal is, like...
Yeah, an animal. Like, no, I meant, like, I normally, like, keep my air, at, like, on the AC setting at, like, 68. I've been trying to keep it on the heat setting at, like, 72.
Why did you do that?
Except for when I sleep and stuff like that. I don't know.
Why are you doing that?
It's not going great. I have to, like, go outside on my balcony, like, a couple times throughout the day to just cool off. Guys, this is my outfit. I didn't do my makeup. I just left my freckles on from earlier. And I'm wearing my nudes shirt and my girlfriend denim jeans. My only focus tonight is to, like, eat. I'm not trying to look cute. I do look cute,
You're
though.
You're so hot.
Yeah. Dad's picking me up right now.
It's cold out. I should have worn my puffer tonight. Instead, I wore it today when it was 70 degrees.
Hello.
Telling you that motherfucker is not real.
I came here for my birthday like 2 years ago and I tipped our server $2,000 and he's our server tonight. And he just brought me free zucchini possums. These are the best. They're like stuffed with ricotta cheese and there's marinara sauce on the side. I got a virgin mojito. I never even get regular mojitos. But I got a virgin cranberry mojito. It sounded good. I get creeped out with mojitos because, like, wet mint leaves creep me out. Especially when you, like, suck them up the straw. Yeah. It tastes like my sleepy girl mocktail that I have every night. Oh, cheers. I don't know. We got autumn harvest vegetables.
Some kind of glazing.
There's a fall. What'd you get?
Like a fettuccine, like Alfredo and black truffles.
Uh-huh. You guys, I got spicy rigatoni vodka with chicken parm on top. By the way, I'm at Crossroads. Everything is vegan. And I don't think I even said that before.
Great. There was spaghetti dish here.
Carbonara. I've been craving banana bread pudding for like weeks now, so I got like, they had like a banana pudding on the dessert menu, so I got it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Happy holidays.
Happy holidays. Oh, have a good night.
My friend. That was the best dinner ever. It is 6:48 and I'm home. I put on my little Christmas top and my I Heart My Boyfriend sweatpants. I'm really upset about these sweatpants because when I ordered them, I don't know, I don't order sweatpants that much. So I just figured I would be an XL because I like things oversized. But they're like way too oversized, so I like can't wear them out of the house. I love eating a little edible before I go to Crossroads for dinner, because then I can just eat so much fucking food, oh my god. I've been thinking about going somewhere this week, just like by myself, like I used to do all the time, because I haven't done that in like a few months. Just because like I love it here, like this is my home, and all that. But I just start to feel like very uninspired when I stay here for too long, like content wise, just cause like I feel like my content's obviously like super repetitive when I'm out here, like I do the same, which I don't mind. Like if I didn't film for a living, like I wouldn't care. Like I'd probably just like be here all the time and obviously not go away as much as I do. But I just love going away by myself to different places and like filming it because I just think that that's so fun. I love travel vlogging for TikTok and YouTube. So if I'm here doing the same shit over and over every day, I start to feel boring and uninspired and just like not as motivated. So I've been thinking about going somewhere this week, maybe from like Monday to like Friday, but I don't know where I want to go. I don't know if I will. I really want to. I've been thinking about it, but I don't know. I originally was like, maybe I'll go to Miami, but the weather is kind of like shit there right now. It's just like cloudy every day. And then I was like, maybe I could just go to like Newport Beach because it's only like 2 hours away, but it's a little chilly in LA right now, obviously. And I want to go somewhere that's like really warm. I don't know. I am going to Illinois in a few weeks. I'm going to Illinois on December 15th through the 23rd to obviously I'm getting like a cute little Airbnb and going there to see my boyfriend and like his family and stuff. And then we're going to New York City on the 20, just on the, oh no, we're going to New York City on the 22nd through the 24th just for a few nights. And then I'm going to Rhode Island for Christmas and I'm going to be there until the 29th, and then I'm going to Nashville with all of my friends for New Year's Eve, and then I'm coming back here. So I could just wait until I do all that, but like I want to go on a trip by myself, you know? So I don't know what I'm gonna do. Maybe I'll do some research tonight again, looking at Airbnbs like every night, but I don't know. I don't know. I haven't used CeraVe like face wash since high school, I think. And I don't even know where this came from. This has just been in my bathroom for like years. And I've been using it. And I've been loving it. I had like a bunch of zits around my mouth and like on my eyebrow. And so I started using this because I was just like, I feel like it's really gentle on my skin. And I've been glowing. So I've been loving the, I use the hydrating one, the CeraVe Hydrating Facial Cleanser.
I keep doing like super strange things at nighttime. Like I'll eat my little edible and I won't even feel high, but then I'll just like do high things. Like last night I was on the phone with Colin and my I was in the kitchen, my phone was on the counter and I'm like looking around. I'm like, where's his voice coming from? Your phone, babe. Okay. I was just going down to the mailroom and I was in the elevator coming up and there was a guy in the elevator with me with a pizza. And I'm standing there, I'm like, oh, I wish I could ask him, like, what kind of pizza he eats, but he won't be able to hear me because I don't have reception in here. Are you standing right there? You're not on the phone with him. Like, I don't know why this keeps happening to me. Colin got me a slaying at anal gift. So, it just arrived, and I'm opening it. What is this?
What do you mean, what is it?
What is this? Colin, what is this?
What do you mean, what is it?
Why is it vacuum sealed? What is it?
Can you not see it yet?
I can... Well... I see the peach emoji. But what is this? Why is it so tightly...
I don't know why it's vacuum sealed. That's interesting.
Dude, this shit's vacuum sealed. It feels like a cement brick. Like, listen to me knocking on it.
Jesus.
You, what is it? Look at it. What is this?
Baby, you look so fucking pretty right now. What do you mean?
Thank you, love. It's gonna like explode when I cut it open.
It's a Sherpa line blanket.
The beach emoji?
Yeah.
Colin. Oh my god, I couldn't tell what it was because it was hard as a brick. I was like, is this a sheet set? I was like, oh god, I hope it's not a sheet set because I'm not putting that on my bed.
No, it's just a throw blanket.
Okay. You're like, all right, baby, go strip the bed and put those on. Oh yeah.
I am a sucker for a good TikTok trend, I will admit. I will say, I fell for the whole sleepy girl mocktail thing. Shit is bomb. I've been making this for, this is my fifth night in a row or sixth night in a row, and I don't think there's gonna be a day on this, that I am on this planet alive, where I don't drink this before I go to sleep. So I put my own little twist on it, and it is the yummiest thing in the whole world. I'll make it at like 9, right? I'll get into bed and I'll sip on it while I'm reading. And then as soon as I'm done with it, I turn the lights off, I go to sleep, knocks me out. And it's the best tasting thing in the world. So I'm gonna show you how I make mine. Tart cherry juice. I get this one from Whole Foods. A scoop of this magnesium powder. I got this one from Moon Juice. I'll link it down below. This is my favorite one ever. And I do a scoop of this, like that much, like a little bit more than a teaspoon, okay? And then I whisk these together with like a little hand mixer. Ice. This part is important. I don't care about your preference. You need to use this exact drink on top. Strawberry vanilla Olipop. On top. Dare I say, this is my most favorite thing that I have ever discovered from TikTok. Mmm. I want to drink it all day. It'll be like noon. I'm like, should I just make one? I'm like, I can't. That defeats the whole purpose. But.
Okay, it's peak and pit time. My peak was I had such a good Pilates class today. Like, it just felt really good. It made me really happy. I had a really good workout. And then after I left, when I went into that little cute coffee shop, I don't know, I just had, like, the nicest conversation with the barista. And it was just something so small like that that just like made my day. Like, I don't know, I just like loved it. I've been making a conscious effort this year to like talk to strangers. Like when I'm in an elevator sometimes, when I'm ordering food at like a counter or like a coffee or something, like I've been making a conscious effort to have conversations with people. I used to just like avoid eye contact and like say as little as possible because that's what was comfortable for me. But it's been really nice, like talking to people. I don't know. It always makes my day whenever I do so. And my pit was, this is such a stupid pit, but I'm just gonna say it because it's the only thing I can think of. There's this dress on For Love and Lemons that I saw on TikTok. Like, and let me just say also, like, it is so hard for me to order dresses online because I most of the time don't like the way I look in certain dresses. So it's really hard for me to like order things like that online, but I know for a fact that For Love and Lemons dresses look amazing on me for the most part. Like a lot of them, they're very flattering for me. And I saw this dress on TikTok a few months ago, a For Love and Lemons dress that was just like, I was like, I need to wear this in Nashville for New Year's Eve weekend. Like I have to, I have to. It's been sold out for months and it's been sold out in my size. Like there was only like an XL available for like months. And then the other day when I checked, there was an extra, extra small available, but that is not my size. But I almost ordered it anyways because I was just like, maybe I could make it work. It would just look really bad, but like maybe I should just do it. I was like, no, I'm gonna wait and see if like an extra small cut. I looked tonight and it's just not looking good for me. I don't think I'm gonna be able to wear it. I even like DM'd them on Instagram. I was like, hey, please help. No response. Wasn't expecting one. That's a stupid pit, but I really wanted to wear that dress in Nashville, and I don't think it's gonna happen. So, thank you guys for hanging out with me today. That was so much fun. We spent Saturday together. I loved every second of it. Make sure to check out Drift. Another fucking peak of mine today was just getting in my car and smelling that. Oh my god, I love Drift. I love their products. So make sure to click the link down below and use my code TARASWRLD for 55% off your first month. It's $5 for your first month. You can't beat it. I love you guys. Thanks for hanging out. I'm gonna sip my sleepy girl mocktail and read my little book and go to sleep and hopefully not have a serving nightmare tonight. That would be nice. I don't like those. Those aren't fun. At least I don't get them twice a week like my poor father. He went on a fucking tangent when I told him today. I was like, Dad, I had a serving nightmare. Okay, good night.